Our portal is a 3D virtual object. So, we need to have some horizontal surface or a plane on which we can place our portal. So, let's see in this tutorial how to detect a horizontal plane. In these tutorials, I'll be following a little different approach. That is, I'll be pasting some lines of code first and then explain you what each line of code means. This will ensure that you understand each and every line of code. Also, I'll be writing comments above each line of code. This will help you to easily refer your code again. So let's start. Just go to your viewWillAppear method, and under this configuration object, I'll write a line of code. Configuration.planeDetection is equal to .horizontal. What this does is, it enables horizontal plane detection. As of now, Apple does not provide vertical plane detection, but in the future updates, it might provide vertical plane detection as well. But for now, there's just horizontal plane detection. Now let's see one of the methods of this arscnviewDelegate. Just type did add and you'll get this first method. Just click on it. So what this method basically does is, it is called whenever a plane is detected, whenever a horizontal plane is detected. From this method, we get a variable known as anchor. Let's see what it means. It says a real world position and orientation that can be used for placing objects in an AR scene. What it means in simple terms is that it basically contains the dimensions as well as the coordinates of the plane that is detected by our camera. Now these anchors can be of many types. One of them is plane anchor. Now we want to check if the anchor that we got from this method is a plane anchor or not. That is, have we really detected a horizontal surface or not? So let's check it. If anchor is AR plane anchor, then execute this line of this block of code, else return. Now, if our anchor is an AR plane anchor, we can safely downcast it to AR plane anchor. Like this, let plane anchor is equal to anchor as AR plane anchor. We now have our plane anchor, that is, we have the dimensions and the coordinates of the plane that is detected. But if we run the code at this point of time, we won't see anything. That is because even if we have detected a horizontal plane, we don't really have a representation of it. So to really see a detected plane, we need to show some shape such as a rectangle to represent our plane so that we are able to see it. So let's create our shape to represent the plane that we detected. The shape can be made using this line of code. It says let plane is equal to SCN plane, and it needs a width parameter and a height parameter. The width is set to planeAnchor.extent.x and height is set to planeAnchor.extent.z. Basically, what it is doing is, it's setting the width of the shape as the width of the plane that we detected as we are using plane anchor. And it's setting the height as the height of the plane that we detected. Now, we have created a rectangular shape to represent our detected plane. But we still don't know where that shape is going to be. That is, we don't know its x, y, and z coordinates. So let's provide our shape some coordinates. Now it can be done through these three lines of code. Now let's see what these three lines of code mean. The first line just creates a node object. A node is basically a 3D coordinate in space. So let's assign our node a position through this line of code. Now what this does is, it says plane node dot position is equal to SCN vector 3, and it has three parameters. The x coordinate is equal to the x coordinate of the plane that we detected. Y coordinate is going to be 0 as the plane sticks to the ground or any surface that we detected. And the z coordinate is equal to the z coordinate of the plane that we detected. Now, what this line of code does is it just simply transforms our shape from XY plane to XZ plane, that it rotates it by 90 degree. It is because by default it is created in XY plane, but we don't need it in XY plane. We need our shape in XZ plane, as the surface that we detected will be in XZ plane. Now we have created a shape as well as we have given it a position. But by default, that shape will be white in color. So let's give that shape an image so that it looks a little bit better. It can be done through these three lines of code. Now let's see what these three lines of code mean. The first two lines just creates a material and assigns an image known as grid.png to this material. The third line just specifies that our shape, that is the plane that we created, will be using this material that we created here. Now, as you can see, we should have this image known as grid.png in our art.scn assets folder, which is right here. But as we can see, we don't have any image as such. So I'm just going to drag this image into this art.scn assets folder. I have this image on my desktop. I'll just drag it into this one. And from here, I'll drag it into art.scn assets folder. You can find this image under this lecture. I have provided this image. You can download it. Now we are almost done. Just last two lines of code left, which is this. So this one, plane node.geometry is equal to plane, just assigns our coordinate to the plane that we created. And this last line just adds our shape to the camera feed. So now let's just run our app and see what we get. So just now you saw that we detected a horizontal plane successfully. But you might have noticed that it takes some time before it detects a plane. That's normal, as it's just trying to gather as much information about the plane as possible so as to give correct results. Now, if you are finding it difficult to detect a plane, I would suggest you to point your app to a horizontal surface which is more textured and a bit rough. And try moving your camera left and right as I did in the video.